This project has a lot of new tools and processes. There will be a step-by-step PowerPoint that you can go through, and we will do this in class together, but it's a good idea when you watch the video to take some notes and definitely bring questions to class. This is a list of some of the tools we'll be introducing and using. One that will take some time to get used to is the transform tool because it does a lot of different things. It can make things bigger or smaller. It can change the width or the height. It can also twist. So it takes a little getting used to that tool. Also, remember to use the tools that we looked at in previous videos, zooming, rotating, moving layers up and down, and saving your files as PNGs or as Krita files. First, we want to create a custom document and make it 1600 by 800 pixels. Next thing we want to do is use the plus button to make a new layer. There's several layers in this video, and one thing we want to learn how to do is manage the layers so they don't get confused. You want to leave your original paint layer alone. We'll use that later at the end of the project. Go to the ink brushes preset, use the marker, and then go to the circle tool and draw your circle, and then double click on that layer and rename it circle. Go back to the brush tool and select marker and then fill in the circle, staying inside the lines. Next, we want to right click on that circle layer and click duplicate layer or mask. So now we have two circles. You won't be able to see the circle because it's right behind the other one. So use the transform tool to move it up a little bit and then use the transform tool to shrink it and put it in position so it looks about like a pear. Next, we want to make a new layer using the plus button and right click or double click on it and call it sides. And then we're going to draw the sides in by hand, but if you have trouble making a smooth line, go to the dynamic brush tool and then play around with the tool options until you find a way to make it easy to make those smooth lines. Next, you want to go to layers on the top left and merge with layer below. And repeat that until the sides and both circles are all one layer, but remember to leave that original paint layer alone. So you have one layer and you're going to double click on that and call it pear. Then you're going to right click on that layer and create a duplicate layer so you have two pear layers. Next, you're going to turn off the eye icon on the original pear layer so you don't see it. And then make a new layer using the plus button and go up to the symmetry tool, which is on the top right, and layer that new layer, label the new layer leaf, and use the symmetry tool to draw a leaf shape. You could use the dynamic brush tool with the symmetry tool if you need it to make a smooth shape. So fill in the leaf and use the transform tool to move it and shrink it and put it in place. Then make a new layer called stem and go to the line tool, which makes straight lines, and make three lines to make this kind of long wedge shape for the stem. Then fill in the stem and use the transform tool to move it into place. So by now you should have a silhouette of the pear all in black. Next, you're going to click on that copy of pear layer, your original pear shape, and click on the alpha lock button to the right of the layer, and then move your advanced color selector to a pear color, like a yellow or green, and then press the alpha lock button on the pear layer, and then just draw using the marker tool, fill in the color in the pear. You won't be able to color outside of the lines with the alpha lock on, so you don't have to worry about staying in the lines at all. Go to the leaf layer and the stem layer and lock alpha on both those layers and pick colors for the stem and the leaf and then color those in using the marker. Once you have your pear, your stem, and your leaf all colored in, merge those three layers until you get one layer that is the pear in all the colors. And then right-click that layer and duplicate the layer and then move the copy of the pear to the side. Next, you're going to make a new layer for shading, and you're going to make a slightly darker color than your original pear color. Increase the size of the marker until you get a big dot like that, and just make that one dot in the middle of the pear on the left. Then use the color picker tool to get back to the original color of your pear and slightly decrease the size of the marker and put a dot over the original dot, leaving some of the darker dot showing so you get kind of a stylized shading, and then shrink the size of your marker even more and pick a lighter color to make a highlight on the top of the pear on the left. Next, you're going to go back to that original pear that doesn't have the stem and hold down shift and pull the pear until it's slightly smaller than the one on the right, and then lock alpha on that layer and color it in a lighter color. You will have to use the up and down, or sorry, the up arrow to move that pear without the stem into the front of the pear on the right. Add another layer called the core and use the symmetry tool to make the shape of the core. Then add another layer for seeds. Use the symmetry layer to make a seed shape. Use the transform tool to shrink it down to the right size and then copy that layer so you have two seeds. So now you've got the front view and the sliced view of the pear. Merge all of your layers except for the original paint layer. Then you can use the fill tool to change the color of the first layer until you get a color that you like. And you want to save this file as it is right now as a PNG. Keep the Krita document open, don't close it, but save it as a PNG so that it's a picture with that particular background color. Then go back to your Krita document. Make sure that you see the PNG somewhere on your desktop or wherever you save it. Then go to your Krita, keep on your Krita file and try some different background colors. And when you get a different one that you like, save it as a PNG also. So you have a few different variations. Next, go to the blending mode up on the top left and change it from normal to overlay and try using your marker in a really big size and just try some different overlay colors, coloring over the top of everything. Sometimes this will eliminate some of your details. If it does, just use the back arrow and try different color variations. You want to have each time you get a variation that you like, just save that one and then save it as a PNG and keep working until you have 6 different variations. So have fun with the colors and exploring these Krita tools, and we will work on this together in class.